Daniela Villani. And I would like to propose you an ESIT protocol, an e-health protocol, aimed to help women with breast cancer to cope with their loss. So, all we know that chemotherapy have a lot of side effects, and among them, sure, hair loss is a very critical one that causes distress to breast cancer women. And frequently is conceived as an avoidable aspect of chemotherapy treatment. So frequently, for example, hair loss is ranked among the first three very important side effects of breast cancer, with nausea and fatigue. And it's described by breast cancer women as causing distress, and for example, also is considered as emblematic of cancer treatment of our cancer diagnosis, and could be also associated with significant changes on body appearance and body image, although not all studies report this association. So why is it difficult to tease out whether alopecia, hair loss alone could impact on stress of breast cancer women? It's commonly recognized that generally, adjustment to cancer, adjustment to diagnosis, and specifically hair loss could impact psychosocial well-being of breast cancer patients. So, how is it possible to help women to cope with this situation? Several studies show that it's possible to help women by giving them the experience of the situation they will have to cope. So up to now, just a few studies have been focused on the anticipation and preparation of an altered appearance. So is the process of preparing patients for hair loss is a significant challenge for healthcare professionals. It consists in a form of anticipatory coping. That is the coping, the acquiring skill to cope with a situation that will appear very soon, very imminently in the future. And typically one of the protocols that could help women or could help people in general to cope with stressful situation is stress inoculation training. Stress inoculation training represents a validated, short, semi-structured and active approach that aim to diminishing the potential for a negative cognitive, emotional, or behavioral reaction. And it's based on the premise that to effectively manage stress, it's crucial to change the way people see the events and how to use their coping skill. So generally, it's implemented through the exposure to stressful situations, stressful stimuli, and this represents the inoculation phases, in combination with the acquisition of effective coping skills that could be, for example, enhanced by integrated relaxation or meditation experience and other emotional management procedures. Typically, the stress inoculation training protocol include three phases that are conceptualization, skill acquisition and rehearsal, and application and follow-through. The conceptualization phase includes the acquisition of knowledge about stress, about the typical responses that people do to stress. And for example, it can be enhanced by the use of mediated experience that integrate video, text, audio that can enhance the knowledge about stress. The second phase is the skill acquisition and rehearsal phase that focus on acquisition of skills to manage emotion, and in this phase is very important, for example, to learn how to cope with the situation, how to manage emotion, and also in our group we test the possibility to support relaxation and meditation experience mediated experience. And the third phase is the application and follow-through phase. In this phase, usually people are required to apply the acquired coping skill in the specific situation, And typically this phase is managed, is supported by, for example, exposure to a stressful situation. And also in this case we can use mediated experience such as virtual reality or such as the use of video to show specific situation in a controlled context where people can live the experience that will be, that will appear very soon. So what we are trying to do with this protocol is to shift from the typical stress inoculation training protocol to an e-health protocol based on this, this focus. So as far as the first phase of our protocol, what we are trying to do, because we are just starting the pilot study, so I'm not presenting data, but just our proposal, protocol proposal, is to carry out the conceptualization phase face-to-face in one session made by the psychologist. And in this session, breast cancer women are invited to reflect on the nature, on the psychological stress due to disease, due to chemotherapy impact, and in particular they will leave a live video simulation about the first chemotherapy session. This is very important because in this live simulation, patients could experience, for example, the waiting phase in the waiting room, the nurse that guide them to the chemotherapy room, and the chemotherapy session in a controlled way with a psychologist that could help them to think about their emotional experience and their concern about the situation. In the second phase consists, that is the skill acquisition and rehearsal phase, consists in 7 sessions that will be made online in 29-minute session. To see once a day. And this session combines 2 different parts. In the first part, patient can watch live video interviews with women with have gone through breast cancer experience, with particular attention to their expectation, their motivation, their emotional reaction, and to chemotherapy side effects and to strategies they have already learned and they have already hacked to cope with changes. In the second part, we include a relaxation based on progressive muscular relaxation and breathing and some meditation experience that are strategies inspired to mindfulness, specifically to contemplation and detached mindfulness, that are proposed to try to give patients some specific strategies they can learn and experience to manage the stress of the situation. And in the third phase, continue the online experience. The first phase is the application and follow-through, and in this phase, as I told you before, patients are asked to apply their acquired coping skill. And also this session, these 3 sessions are carried out online. And also this phase includes sessions that combine 2 different phases. In the first part, video life of breast cancer patients interviews currently undergoing chemotherapy treatment, as you can see in the picture, both with and without wigs are presented. In this way, women can really directly deal with changes due to illness, due to chemotherapy, and to some strategies that people have been made to cope with the situation. And in addition, there are some suggestions that patients that already experienced the situation can give to new patients. So it's a very important phase. And secondly, in the same session, there are also, like in the previous session, some relaxing experiences that, again, integrate relaxation and meditation experience. So, as I told you, we are just starting the pilot study, so we have no data, not yet. Just to show you the study flow and to specify how is lasting the whole protocol. The protocol will start with the conceptualization phase made face-to-face with the psychologist and will end with the psychologist face-to-face. But the 10 sessions that covered the two phases of the skill acquisition and application phases will be made online. So patient will access to an website where they can find all the mediated experience to made once a day. And then we will have also a follow-up session that will be made at distance, probably by telephone or by email, just because probably our experience, we know that probably patient will continue the chemotherapy, all will be finished and probably will be regain their actual life, so maybe they rework again, and it will be difficult to have them again at the hospital. The website will offer, the website conilsenodipoi.it will offer the possibility to access to the introduction to the experience where all the patients can find also psychologist contact and all the researcher contact, so for any problem they can be helped also during the distance protocol, and every mediated experience will be made just once a day, so they cannot do, for example, two different sessions in one day because they are blocked from the website. And before and after each experience, they have to fill out a questionnaire about aims to monitoring their emotional state. And in this way, they can live this mediated experience in their comfortable situation, for example, at home. And this represents, sure, a challenge to help them in their natural setting and natural situation. The hospital that are involved in the project are three hospitals in Milan and close to Milan. That are Guido Salvini Hospital, San Giuseppe Multimedica Hospital, and Luigi Sacco Hospital. And as far as the trial, we are thinking about compare two groups. And so the oncologist of these three hospitals will propose the research to all breast cancer patients, which is offered chemotherapy that are fulfilling these criteria. These inclusion criteria that are diagnosis of breast cancer radically operated, negative stage of disease metastasis, and suitability of adjustment chemotherapy with anthracycline and taxane. And the trial will include 50 women with age ranging between 30 and 70 years that will be randomized in two groups. The experimental groups that will follow the ECIT protocol as an adjunct to treatment as usual for 2 weeks, and the control group that will receive the usual care for 2 weeks. The assessment will be based as far as the online session by asking patients to fill in the vast scale about their emotional state before and after each mediated experience, but also at the beginning and at the end of the treatment, when patient will meet the psychologist, they will be asked to fill in some specific self-report questionnaire, aiming to evaluate their psychological well-being, their adjustment to cancer, and their emotional regulation skill. And 3 months follow-up include the same questionnaire. So to conclude, I think that patient education and the use of computer-based approach or imagery intervention or virtual reality or simulation could represent an effective strategy to help people suffering of different conditions to be prepared of the situation that imminently will appear. And integrated technology with in psychological intervention, focusing on both on physical side effects and on the emotional and psychological, for example, effects of chemotherapy, could represent a promising approach to facilitate coping and also adjustment to diagnosis and to cancer and to treatment side effects. So we think that ECIT protocol represents a promising approach to help women to cope with the stressful experience of chemotherapy and specifically with their loss. And nevertheless, control study, and we are starting with this goal, should test the effectiveness of this approach to effectively show that this proposal could be really effective. Thank you.